So hello everyone and welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247 where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news. This session guys is helpful for various government exams, specifically for RBI Grade B and NABARD's ESI section. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are new here, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. So let's move ahead to the question number one. For which state's electricity supply Asian Development Bank has sanctioned the first tranche of $300 million loan? कौन से स्टेट के इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सप्लाई के लिए एशियन डेवलपमेंट बैंक ने $300 million का सैंक्शन दिया है? So let's talk about this loan guys. So Asian Development Bank and the government of India has signed a loan worth $300 million and this loan guys has been signed to upgrade the rural power distribution network to provide effective electricity supply in the rural areas in the state of Uttar Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh के जो rural areas है वहां पे proper electricity पहुंचाने के लिए और जो उनका power distribution network है उसको strong बनाने के लिए this loan has been sanctioned. And remember this is the first tranche. Okay, the overall project cost is how much? $430 million. So rest $130 million will be provided by Asian Development Bank later. Okay. And talking more about the project, so guys, this project aimed at creating a robust distribution network that will benefit an estimated 70 million people in Uttar Pradesh. Okay, so I hope guys, this news is clear. इसमें से ज़्यादा नहीं पढ़ना. You just have to remember कि कौन से state के लिए loan दिया गया है, total project cost कितनी है और किसने दिया है. Okay, so therefore the correct answer is what? Option B, Uttar Pradesh. Okay, option B, Uttar Pradesh is the correct answer. And talking more about this project, so guys, through this project, there will be establishment of separate feeders for electricity supply to both agriculture and the residential consumers. जो residential consumers और agriculture है उनके लिए separate feeders बनाए जाएंगे ताकि proper rationing हो सके. And this project will also strengthen the financial management of the power distribution entities in the state. Okay, जो उनका financial management है उसको भी strengthen करेगा. किनका? जो power distribution entities है in the Uttar Pradesh. Okay, so therefore the correct answer is what? Option B, Uttar Pradesh. And now let's move on to question number two. Recently 5 MOUs have been signed by the Ministry of Food Processing Industry, and who is the Minister of Food Processing Industry? It's Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar. For effective implementation of PM FME scheme. Now what is this PM FME scheme? Prime Minister Formalization of Micro Food Processing Enterprises scheme. This scheme guys was launched this year only. So the question is, with which of the following organization this MOU has not been signed? इसमें से कौन सी organization के साथ ये MOU signed नहीं हुए हैं? So total guys 5 MOU signed हुए हैं, एक agreement signed हुआ है और एक joint communique है with the Ministry of Tribal Affairs. So let's talk about this news. So as I told you, there is one joint communique with the Ministry of Tribal Affairs and between the Ministry of Tribal Affairs and the Ministry of Food Processing Industry, and with these 5 organizations 5 MOUs have been signed. Number one is TriFed, then we have ICAR, National Scheduled Caste Finance and Development Corporation, NCDC and NAFED. In panchon ke sath MOU sign kiya gaya hai for effective implementation of PM FME scheme. And also Union Bank of India ke sath agreement sign hua hai. There is an agreement with the Union Bank of India to act as a nodal bank for the implementation of PM FME scheme. All right. So Union Bank jo hoga wo nodal bank hoga, wo subsidies wagera jo bhi provide karai jayengi. That will be through the Union Bank of India. And now talking about the purposes of MOU, ये जो 5 अलग-अलग MOU sign हुए हैं, या ये जो agreement sign हुआ है, या जो joint communique है, इनका purpose क्या है? What is the purpose of all these? So let's talk about the first joint communique between the Ministry of Tribal Affairs and the Ministry of Food Processing Industry. So this communique would enable easier identification of the tribal people, tribal enterprises. Okay. इससे क्या होगा? जो ट्राइबल एंटरप्राइजेस है उनको आइडेंटिफाई करना आसान होगा एंड द ग्रुप्स इन फूड प्रोसेसिंग सेक्टर इंक्लूडिंग माइनर फॉरेस्ट प्रोड्यूस. ओके, देन द एमओयू विद ट्राइफेड वुड हेल्प इन ब्रांडिंग ऑफ फूड प्रोडक्ट्स अंडर इट्स ट्राई फूड प्रोजेक्ट. एमओयू विद आईसीएआर वुड हेल्प इन शेयरिंग फूड प्रोसेसिंग टेक्नोलॉजी, पैकिंग एंड मशीनरी डेवलपमेंट इन द फूड प्रोसेसिंग सेक्टर. देन जो एनएसएफडीसी के साथ होगा, दैट विल इनेबल द कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग, नॉलेज शेयरिंग ऑफ द एससी कम्युनिटीज ऑफ द सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप्स. ऑलराइट, एंड एमओयू विद नाफेड वुड हेल्प इन डेवलपिंग न्यू ब्रांड फॉर द नाफेड फूड प्रोडक्ट्स. अदर देन दिस, जो एनसीडीसी के साथ एमओयू है, दैट विल हेल्प इन प्रिपेयरिंग द प्रोजेक्ट्स एंड डिटेल प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट्स ऑफ द मेंबर्स ऑफ कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज व्हिच आर वर्किंग इन द फूड प्रोसेसिंग सेक्टर. एंड यूनियन बैंक ऑफ इंडिया गाइज वुड हेल्प इन ट्रांसफरिंग द सब्सिडी रिसीव फ्रॉम द सेंटर एंड स्टेट्स into the loan accounts. Okay, So ये जितने भी पांच MOUs हैं, they all have the different purposes. So remember this, and these MOUs and this joint communique and this agreement with Union Bank of India have been signed for effective implementation of Prime Minister's food processing formalization of micro food processing industries enterprises. Okay. So now let's come back to the question. So the question is, with which of the following organizations this MOU has not been signed? So this organization, NAFED is there, TRIFED is there, NCDC is there, ICAR is there, FSSAI is not there, guys. So therefore option D, FSSAI will be the correct answer. And now can you tell me who is the CEO of FSSAI? Write down in the comments. And now let's move on to question number 3. Consider the following statements regarding the first Center of Excellence for Skill Development in Power Sector, and you have to identify the correct statement. So guys, pehla Center of Excellence established hua hai in the power sector for skilling. So uske bare mein hame correct statement batani hai. So let's talk about the news first. What is the news? The first Center of Excellence for Skill Development in Power Sector has been established where? At the National Institute of Solar Energy, which is in Gurugram. Okay, and Gurugram of course is in Haryana. And it is a joint initiative, guys, of the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Ministry of National Education and Youth of France, and Schneider Electric, which is a private company. So, in tino ka ye joint initiative hai. Pehla kaun hai? Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, hamare desh ka, Government of India ka. Then the Ministry of National Education and Youth of France and Schneider Electric. Okay. And talking more about this project, so this center, guys, has been inaugurated by Mr. R.K. Singh. Mr. R.K. Singh, who is the Minister of State in the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, and of course, he is also the Minister of New and Renewable Energy, and of course, he is also the Minister of Power. Okay, and this Center of Excellence, guys, it is a result of the MOUs signed earlier between the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Ministry of Education of France, and this company Schneider Electric. ये पहले ही इनके बीच में MOU signed हुआ था. उसी का ये रिजल्ट है. उस एमओयू के तहत इस सेंटर ऑफ एक्सीलेंस को एस्टैब्लिश किया गया है. ओके, एंड देयर इज वन ऑपरेशनल एमओयू आल्सो. ओके, एक ऑपरेशनल एमओयू है जिसके थ्रू इस पूरे सेंटर ऑफ एक्सीलेंस को ऑपरेशनलाइज किया जाएगा. दैट वाज साइंड बिटवीन नेशनल स्किल डेवलपमेंट कॉर्पोरेशन, Schneider इलेक्ट्रिक इंडिया, ओके, पावर सेक्टर स्किल काउंसिल एंड नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ सोलर एनर्जी विच इज इन गुरुग्राम. ऑलराइट, सो दैट इज अबाउट दिस न्यूज. एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. So you have to identify the correct statements. It has been inaugurated at the campus of National Institute of Solar Energy in Gurugram. Yes, this is absolutely correct. It is a joint initiative of Ministry of Power, Government of India, Ministry of Education, France, and Schneider Electric. Guys, these two are correct. Ministry of Education from France is included. Schneider Electric is also there, but Ministry of Power is not there. It is the joint initiative of Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. Okay, so which means this statement we have is incorrect. And it has been inaugurated by Rajkumar Singh. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Rajkumar Singh, R.K. Singh, ek hi baat hai. So we have two statements which are correct here, 1 and 3, which means let us say this is 3. Only 1 and 3. So option E, only 1 and 3 will be the correct answer. And now let's move on to question number 4. Who won the first prize in Deen Dayal Upadhyay Telecom Skill Excellence Awards? So, ये Telecom Skill Excellence Award दिए गए हैं by the Ministry of Communication, Information Technology and Electronics, and for his contribution in deep sea communication, facilitating communication among the fishermen. So, let's talk about these awards first, and then we'll move on to the question. So, Ministry of Communication and Electronics and IT. And who is the Minister of Communication and Electronics? It's Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad. His Lok Sabha constituency is Patna Sahib in Bihar. So this ministry has presented this award, Deen Dayal Upadhyay Telecom Skill Excellence Awards. And why these awards have been given? So these awards, guys, have been given to reward the successful telecom skilled people for their contribution in the telecom sector. Or telecom sector mein kahin pe bhi, like in the telecom services, manufacturing, telecom applications, scaling. Kahin pe bhi agar koi bhi kisi bhi tarike ka contribution hai telecom sector mein, jo ki bahut effective hai. And those people have been given these awards. Okay. And what about the first prize? First prize kisko mila hai? So it's Mr. Srinivas Karnam. Okay. Mr. Srinivas Karnam. Aur kyun mila hai? For his contribution in developing a cost effective customized technical solution under the brand C Mobile. Remember the brand name C Mobile. Okay. For deep sea communication that facilitates the communication between the fishermen. Aur abhi ye Kerala coast pe installed hai. Iske alawa government is planning to install it on the other coast as well. And what is the कैश अवार्ड दैट हैज बीन गिवन, ₹50,000 का फर्स्ट प्राइज एंड ₹30,000 का सेकंड प्राइज है. एंड किसको मिला है सेकंड प्राइज? इट्स मिस्टर इट्स प्रोफेसर शुभ्रत कर. एंड व्हाई? फॉर हिज इनोवेटिव सॉल्यूशन ऑन डेवलपमेंट एंड डिप्लॉयमेंट ऑन अ लार्ज स्केल सेंसर नेटवर्क एंड डिवाइसेस टू अवॉइड ट्रेन एनिमल कोलिजन. सो आप सबने सुना होगा ट्रेन एनिमल कोलिजन के बारे में काफी ज्यादा है. एक प्रोजेक्ट बी भी लॉन्च किया गया था जिसमें बी के साउंड से एलिफेंट को दूर भगाया जाता है. ओके, सो ट्रेन और एनिमल के कोलिजन को दूर करने के लिए उनका एक प्रोजेक्ट है जिसके लिए ही हैज वन दिस अवार्ड, प्रोफेसर शुभ्रतकर. एंड व्हाट इज द अमाउंट ऑफ अवार्ड? ₹30,000. ओके, सो दैट्स इट अबाउट दिस न्यूज. एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. हु वन द फर्स्ट प्राइज? सो द क्वेश्चन इज अबाउट द फर्स्ट प्राइज. सो इट्स मिस्टर श्रीनिवास कर्णम फॉर his contribution in the deep sea communication that facilitates the communication between the fishermen. Okay, now let's move on to the question number 5, which is the last question for today. Consider the following statements regarding National Hydrology Project. Now, what is this National Hydrology Project? Why we are discussing it? And identify the correct statement. You have to identify the correct statement. So, we are discussing guys National Hydrology Project because recently the Union Minister of Jal Shakti has reviewed its midterm, has taken its midterm review. Okay, so that is why it was in news and that's why we are studying it. So let's talk about the National Hydrology Project. So what is the objective of this project? So its objective is to improve the extent, reliability and accessibility of water resources information. जो भी हमारे देश के water resources information है उनकी reliability और उनको accessibility को improve करना है. एंड टू स्ट्रेंथन द कैपेसिटी ऑफ वाटर रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट इंस्टीट्यूशन इन इंडिया. जितने भी हमारे देश के वाटर रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट इंस्टीट्यूशन है उनकी कैपेसिटी को स्ट्रेंथन करना. इट वॉज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 2016 एज अ सेंट्रल सेक्टर स्कीम, विच मीन 100% फंडिंग इज प्रोवाइडेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. बट रिमेंबर दिस प्रोजेक्ट इज सपोर्टेड बाय वर्ल्ड बैंक. ओके, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कोर्स इज मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ जल शक्ति सपोर्टेड बाय द वर्ल्ड बैंक. And budget outlay is how much? ₹3,680 crores for a period of 8 years. And who are the beneficiaries? इसमें किसको फायदा मिलेगा? So the central and state implementing agencies responsible for surface or groundwater planning and management. उनको फायदा मिलेगा. Other than this, users of the water resource information system across various sectors across the globe. Okay, उन ये दो type के beneficiaries हैं in the National Hydrology Project. And remember, we are discussing it because it was in news for its midterm review. Okay, so let's come back to the question. Now you have to identify the correct statement. It was launched in 2015. So it wasn't launched guys in 2015, it was in 2016 that it was launched. So this statement is incorrect. Then the project is supported by the Asian Development Bank. So is that Asian Development Bank? No, it's World Bank, which means this statement is also incorrect. And it has budgetary outlay of ₹3,680 crores. This is absolutely correct, which means we have only one correct statement here. Option C, only 3 will be the correct answer. Okay, and guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the news are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.